Hello and welcome to Muncaster. Perched above the River Esk in the Western Lake District stands Muncaster Castle. Home to the Pennington family for over 800 years, the castle and its extensive grounds are now open to the public for all to enjoy. The castle has been added to and amended many times over the centuries, leaving us with the impressive structure we have today. Parts of the present castle building, such as the southeast peel tower, date back to the 14th century, having replaced an earlier structure built on the same site. The large library was added in the late 17th to early 18th century. The drawing room, with its wonderful barrel ceiling, was converted from a courtyard in the 1800s and redecorated in 1958. The northwest peel tower was also added in the 1800s to mirror the original medieval one. Visiting the castle and entering its ancient walls, you can explore an array of rooms at ground level and above, from the formal dining room to the eerie tapestry room, believed by many to be haunted. Muncaster is reputedly one of the most haunted buildings in Britain, with several visitors experiencing strange goings-on. The tapestry room is still used as a guest bedroom by the Pennington family, and often visitors staying in the room have heard the ghostly cries of a child, sometimes followed by the gentle singing of someone trying to calm the crying infant. Others have heard footsteps outside the room, as well as having seen the door handle turning, but not opening. Elsewhere in the castle and grounds, the mischievous spirit of Tom Fool has been known to play tricks on people. Tom was a jester at the castle in the 1500s who murdered a young man and was believed to send people to their deaths in the Esk if he didn't take to them. The White Lady has also been spotted wandering the roads near Muncaster. This is believed to be the ghost of Mary Bragg, a young girl murdered in the early 1800s on the road near the main gate. Whether these ghosts are real or not is up to you, but if you are brave enough, you could always go on one of our ghost sits or overnight vigils to judge for yourself. The castle itself sits among vast gardens and grounds stretching out around the building. As you arrive at Muncaster, you have a gentle walk along the drive surrounded by trees and plants from around the world, providing an array of colour. Elsewhere in the grounds, you can enjoy the Georgian terrace that stretches for over 500 metres with beautiful box hedges, stunning views of the Esk Valley and two small summer houses to relax in. To the south of the castle, you can find the wild meadow with its wide variety of flowers. Stretching off to the west are large swathes of woodland to wander through, and in the spring months, you can enjoy bluebell heaven. While you explore the gardens, don't forget the Max Meadow Vole Maze, a must for children. Shrink down to the size of a meadow vole to find your way through the maze and learn what dangers a vole might face. You can also take the time to spot the herons that nest and feed in the trees around the castle. At 4 p.m. every day, we have Heron Happy Hour, where you can witness their feeding. Here at Muncaster, we host a huge variety of different events throughout the year for all to enjoy. Our event season starts in May with the Muncaster Festival, including the world-famous annual Fools Competition. In the summer, we have a Living History Week where you can take trips back in time to discover life in the Viking Age, the Norman period, and during the Wars of the Roses. October, and the castle goes dark for Halloween week. Ghosts and ghouls take over with ghostly castle tours and the spooky, scary maze. The season comes to an end with Christmas at Muncaster, where you can enjoy the Taste of Cumbria Market, Victorian castle tours, and Christmas entertainment throughout December. There is so much to see and do at Muncaster. We hope you can come and explore here soon.